In this video tutorial, you will be learning how to use Desmos for creating interactive plots like this, provided that you know some basic conventions in plotting and math. Although this tutorial uses the web version of Desmos, you can use the mobile Desmos app from Google Play Store, only that you have to work on a smaller screen. You can find more links and information about this tutorial in the description below. So, without further interruptions, let's get started. Points and sliders make Desmos interactive. In Desmos, interactive plots are created by constraining points and sliders in a specific way. Everything in the plot can be controlled interactively by dragging either of the two. Consequently, by incorporating the variables of these points and sliders inside each mathematical statement expressing a visual plot, we can interactively transform the shapes of curves. Let us start with a point, dragging a point freely. Points can freely be moved in the coordinate plane. To make a point, we simply need to have two variables to define the x and y coordinates. Let us say we want to start with a point in the origin, so we type AB and set A equals 0 and B equals 0. Points can be moved by dragging. The motion path of a point from dragging can be constrained parallel to the x-axis, y-axis, or both. In order to change the constraint for the motion path of the point, we simply need to click and hold for a second the circular icon of a rectangular row containing the selected mathematical statement in this column. Generally speaking, all these circular icons change the visual and interactive properties of the mathematical statements inside the rows. Moving the point using our own cursor, here is the horizontal constraint, vertical constraint, and the free constraint. Dragging a point in the predefined path. In order to constrain the point to move in a predefined path, we need to Step 1. Express the path as a parametric equation supplied with the necessary variables around controlled by a single variable for both the x and y coordinates. Step 2. Make the sliders. In addition, a point can be labeled by checking this box and entering our string of text. By default, the point is labeled with its numerical x and y coordinates. The placement of the label can be adjusted by selecting these options. The visual appearance of a point can be hidden or visible just by right-clicking this circular icon. Slider. Let us start by declaring a variable with any value we like, say h is equal to 0. Upon pressing enter, the variable will automatically have a slider with a range of values from negative 10 to positive 10. The range of the slider can be changed, clicking it, and typing the desired range of values. The step of a slider controls the smoothness of its adjustment behavior. If you want continuous or fine adjustment, then do not put a step value. If you want a discrete or coarse adjustment, then put a specified step value. A slider essentially controls the value of a variable by sliding this point in a specified range of values. Variables can control the numerical value of mathematical expressions, and the expressions can in turn control what is plotted in your screen. That's all. If you have liked the video, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Comment if you want, subscribe for more informative videos like these.